Professor Dave here. Let's talk about parametric equations.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
By now, we are quite familiar with equations where y is expressed in terms of x, and we have learned about a variety of different types of equations that work this way. We also just learned about polar equations, where r is expressed in terms of theta. But there is one more type of equation we will want to briefly mention, and those are parametric equations. These are sets of equations in which the x and y values are calculated in separate equations, and each dependent on some other variable. The most common application of this involves two-dimensional motion of objects, like projectile motion. We learned all about this in the classical physics course, so you can head there if you want more information about this subject. But the basic gist of it is that when you throw a ball into the air at an angle, its x and y motion are independent of one another. Its horizontal velocity will be constant if we ignore wind resistance, but its vertical velocity will be constantly decreasing from the moment of release because gravity will be continuously accelerating the ball in the negative direction towards the ground. So in such a case, it can make sense to have an equation that models the x-coordinate of the ball with respect to time, and an equation that models the y-coordinate of the ball with respect to time, as they do indeed depend on the parameter of time differently, and we may sometimes want to ask a question about one of these values and not the other. So we can say that in general, sets of parametric equations come in the form of x equals f of t and y equals g of t. These are two separate functions, but they depend on the same parameter. Then to graph the plane curve that results, we can just plug in some values of t and see what we get. For example, let's look at the parametric equations x equals 2t and y equals t squared. Let's make a little table, pick some t values, and then find the corresponding x and y values. Once we have all of these, we essentially have a set of x and y coordinates, so we can now plot all of these points, connect them, and we see that we get a parabola. We can quite easily get the equation for this parabola by doing something called eliminating the variable. This is where we solve for t in one of the equations and plug it into the other. Using this one, t must be equal to x over 2, so let's plug x over 2 into the other equation, and we get y equals x squared over 4, or 1/4 x squared. Depending on the situation, it can be easier to plot points using the parametric equations, or to find a way to eliminate the parameter and just graph it normally. There are different situations that would favor one approach over the other. For example, if using a graphing calculator, it can be easier to enter the equation of something like an ellipse in parametric form rather than rectangular. But an ability to understand how to move between these two types of equations is all we really need. So let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.